The purpose of this video lecture is to learn about cardiac output and the factors affecting cardiac output. To begin, let's define cardiac output, abbreviated CO. Cardiac output is defined as the rate at which a ventricle pumps blood. The units are expressed as liters per minute. The normal cardiac output is 5 liters per minute. Cardiac output can be calculated by multiplying heart rate times stroke volume. Let's talk about each of these variables. First, heart rate. Heart rate is measured as beats per minute, abbreviated BPM. The average heart rate is about 70 beats per minute. The heart rate is set by the SA node. Second is stroke volume. Stroke volume is the volume of blood pumped per beat or stroke, and that's about 70 milliliters per beat. The abbreviation for stroke volume is SV. Stroke volume can be calculated by subtracting the end diastolic volume, the EDV, minus the end systolic volume, ESV. So let's go ahead and define these terms. For end diastolic volume, first think about the word diastole. What does that word mean? It means relaxation of the ventricles. And we use the word end, and we use the word end. So end diastolic is the end of relaxation, which is right before the heart muscle contracts. And the word volume pertains to the volume of blood in the ventricles. So when we put all these words together, EDV, end diastolic volume, means the maximum amount of blood in the ventricles before contraction. Now for end systolic volume, again, first think about the word systole. What does that word mean? It means contraction of the ventricles. And we use the word end, so end systolic is the end of contraction, which is right before the heart muscle relaxes. And again, the word volume pertains to the volume of blood in the ventricles. So, when we put all these words together, the end systolic volume, ESV, means the maximum amount of blood in the ventricles after contraction. So before we proceed any further, let's make sure that we are all on the same page regarding the right and left ventricles. The volume of blood that is pumped by each ventricle, meaning the right and the left ventricle, is the same. The volume of blood coming out of the right and left ventricle is the same. That's an important concept. The pressures, however, are different. The pressure in the left ventricle is higher than the pressure in the right ventricle. But again, remember, the volume of blood is the same. Now, let's return to cardiac output and explore how heart rate and stroke volume affect cardiac output. Remember that we calculate cardiac output by multiplying heart rate times stroke volume. So if heart rate increases, cardiac output increases, or if stroke volume decreases, cardiac output decreases, and so on. So let's go ahead and zoom in on these factors. We're going to begin with heart rate. So here are the factors that regulate heart rate. Neural control via the autonomic nervous system can regulate heart rate. More specifically, the parasympathetic nervous system will lower heart rate, while the sympathetic nervous system will raise heart rate. But it's not just the autonomic nervous system that regulates heart rate. Hormones are also involved. These hormones include epinephrine, which you already know is released as a result of sympathetic stimulation, but there is also thyroid hormone. Thyroid hormone actually enhances the effects of epinephrine. So if you have chronic hyperthyroidism, meaning an abnormally high level of thyroid hormone, this can actually weaken the heart because thyroid hormone not only increases heart rate, it also increases force of contraction. Those are the factors that regulate heart rate. In a separate video, we will discuss the mechanism for the sympathetic and parasympathetic effect on heart rate. So now, let's focus on stroke volume. Stroke volume is regulated by 2 different factors. The end diastolic volume and ventricular contractility. So let's focus on end diastolic volume first. Remember to always define the terms. This will help you a lot. So end diastolic volume is the maximum amount of blood in the ventricles before contraction. This is influenced by Starling's law. Starling's law is the rate at which blood flows into the heart. Some people will refer to this as preload. So if I increase the rate of blood flow into the heart, that means I have increased venous return. If I increase venous return, that will increase end diastolic volume. Now, let's focus on the factors that affect ventricular contractility. Remember, this is the other factor that affects stroke volume. Ventricular contractility is affected by the sympathetic nervous system. The sympathetic nervous system increases the force of contraction. We will discuss the mechanism for that in a separate video. There are also hormones that can affect ventricular contractility: insulin, glucagon, thyroid hormone, and epinephrine will all increase the force of ventricular contraction.